Applications for removal of impacted mandibular third molars, the first and foremost important indication for the removal is pericoronitis. Pericoronitis. Pericoronitis is the inflammation and swelling of the gingival tissue covering the crown of the partially impacted teeth. Okay, so the first attack of pericoronitis is not considered as a removal. It may conservatively managed, but the second and subsequent attacks, that is recurrent pericoronitis, is most important and main indication for removal of the impacted third molars. The pericoronitis is asked as short answer question, so we'll make separate video on pericoronitis. And the second most important indication is dental caries, DC. Okay, dental caries. Especially in cases of mesoangular impactions, what will happen is okay, this is second molar and this is mesoangular impacted teeth. So in between the third molar and second molar, in this junction, the food will get accumulated. Okay, there is food impaction here. So obviously on land standing, this area will develop dental caries. So dental caries will affect both second molar and third molar also. Okay, so in these cases, to save the second molar, we'll go for removal of the third molar and root canal of the second molar. Then third one is periodontal disease. Periodontal disease, especially in mesoangular impaction cases, okay, due to this dental caries or food impaction, there is distal pocket. The pocket or periodontal disease will initiate at the distal aspect of second molar. Okay, so in those cases also, we'll go for removal of the impacted third molar. Okay, then fourth one is cystic changes. Cystic changes. There is ample evidence to say that the follicle covering the impacted third molar will show the changes of dentigerous cyst or odontogenic cyst or ameloblastoma. So from the follicle of third molar, this dentigerous cyst, OKC, keratocyst, okay, and ameloblast will develop in some cases. So to avoid that, or those cases showing these changes, will obviously go for removal of this third molar. Okay, then the fifth one is to prevent the mandibular angle fracture. To prevent mandibular angle fracture. So this area is angle, obviously the area of mandibular third molar is mandibular angle region. So in mandibular angle region, the most of the area is occupied by the impacted third molars, decreasing the bone density or bone mass in this angle fracture, angle region. So if there is any traumatic injury to that region, mandibular angle region, due to the less bone density or bone mass, the obvious part going to fracture is mandibular angle. Okay, so if you go for removal of the third molar in that socket, the socket of third molar will get ossified in due course in 3 to 4 months. So that will reduce the mandibular angle fractures. Okay, then as a preparatory caution to the orthognathic surgeries, that means before orthognathic surgery, okay, especially in BSS cases, that is bilateral sagittal split osteotomy, to prevent the bad splits, will remove the third molars approximately 6 months before the surgery. Okay, if there is third molar, when you are giving the cuts, in BSSO, there are three cuts, medial cut, vertical cut, and oblique cut. Okay? So, when you are preparing these cuts, if there is third molar, this will lead to unwanted fractures. That is called as bad splits. So, to avoid the bad splits, we'll go for removal of the third molars. Then, seventh place is, as a preparation to the orthodontic treatment. Before orthodontic treatment. So, what happens? The force, the erupting force of third molars will result in the lower anterior crowding. That is called as imbrication. Okay? So, if you are planning to go for correction of crowding or any orthodontic treatment, if there is third molar, preferably orthodontist will suggest to remove the third molar before the treatment. Because once the treatment and once the malocclusion is corrected, the forces from the third molar, erupting third molar, will again result in relapse. Okay? So other indications includes recurrent cheek bite. Okay? Due to the buccally erupted impacted teeth or due to operculum, that is soft tissue covering the partially erupted third molar, there is recurrent cheek bite that will result in premalignant or malignant lesions. So, in recurrent cheek bite cases also, we go for removal. Then, teeth in line of fracture, especially in mandibular angle fractures, if the fracture line runs through the impacted mandibular third molar, okay, in those cases, if it is completely luxated from its socket and if it is fractured, the tooth itself get fractured, in those cases only we are going for removal of third molar, not in all cases. Okay, if the third molar gets luxated and if the third molar tooth itself get fractured, in those cases we go for removal of third molar. Then prosthodontic treatment, that is before going for fabrication of complete dentures, if the impacted tooth is covered with only soft tissue or 1 to 2 mm of bone, in those cases we must remove the impacted third molar first, then fabricate the complete denture. Otherwise, the pressure from the complete denture will result in bone resorption and ultimate exposure of this impacted tooth, that will result in pain. Okay? Then systemic reason. The systemic reasons, the infected or decayed mandibular third molar will act as a persistent foci of infection. So there are some studies which saying there is connection between the oral cavity, oral hygiene, and the cardiac diseases. So to avoid any systemic infectious spot, we are going to remove the third molars. Then pain of unexplained origin, that is pain in the mandibular angle region. Those cases also we will go for removal of third molar. And root resorption, okay, especially in mesioangular impactions, the erupting force of mesioangular impaction will result in resorption of the second molar root. Just like the succedaneous teeth resorbs the roots of primary teeth as a process of normal eruption. Okay, so in those cases also we are going for removal of third molar. These are the main indications for removal of third molar. Coming to the contraindications, extremes of age, that is if the patient is too old, he may not support the surgical procedure, and in old age the bone becomes too densified, that is too inelastic, so the removing procedure is difficult. Okay, and the second one is proximity to vital structures, especially inferior alveolar nerve. Okay, the third molar roots may impinge or may associated with the inferior alveolar nerve. In those cases also, the elevation, while removing the tooth, if you luxate, those luxatory forces may damage the inferior alveolar nerve. Then coming to the economic constraints. That means the all patient may not afford the surgical removal of third molars. These are the some of the contraindications. Coming to the complications of impacted third molar removal. So these complications can be divided into intraoperative complications and postoperative complications. That means when you are doing the procedure, the first one is you may encounter the bleeding. Okay, the intraoperative complications include, first thing, bleeding. Okay, bleeding may be due to the injury to the inferior alveolar artery, or it may be due to from the bone. So if there is bone bleeding, you must apply bone wax. Okay, or if there is bleeding of this inferior alveolar artery, in those cases what will you do is you apply pressure packing. You apply pressure pack into the socket for at least 4 to 5 minutes, then obviously the bleeding will stop. Okay, so the first complication is bleeding, and the second complication is you may injure the lingual nerve. You may injure the lingual nerve when you are giving the incision. Okay, the lingual nerve is located, say this is the second molar or third molar. Okay, from this aspect, this is the bone. Okay, so this is lingual cortical plate. Lingual nerve is located from this lingual cortical plate 0.58 mm lingually, and 2.28 mm inferiorly. Okay, this is lingual cortical plate. Okay, from lingual cortex, lingual nerve is located approximately 2.28 mm inferiorly. Okay, and from the lingual cortical plate, lingual nerve is located 0.58 mm lingually. So this is the lingual nerve location. If you are distal extension incision straightly goes posteriorly, then there is possible chances of injuring lingual nerve. That is why distal extension incision, that is limb C, must be extended laterally towards the cheek. It should not go straight posteriorly. It must be extended laterally to avoid the injury to lingual nerve. Okay, then postoperatively, there would be wound dehiscence. That means whatever suture you place, that will break. The wound dehiscence, it may result in failure to wound healing. Otherwise, it may result in food lodgment. Okay, and most important postoperative complications of removing mandibular third molar is dry socket. That is non-healing socket. Okay, dry socket. Dry socket is generally, it produces intense pain on third day onwards. It will not produce first day or second. The pain will intensify after third day. So dry socket can be asked as 4 marks question, that is short answer question. So we'll prepare a separate video on dry socket. Okay, so these are some possible complications. So for essay questions, this topic must be discussed in all these side headings. Thank you. If you like the video, subscribe the channel, and if you have any doubts, mention in the comment box.